Today, I'm going to show you how to export the standard dagger from Elden Ring and turn it into a kris dagger using Blender. Then we'll go ahead and import that back into Elden Ring using a model swap. To do this, here's what we're going to need. Blender, Soulstruct for Blender, UXM Selective Unpacker, WitchyBND, Pears Flavor Editor, and Modengine 2. All of the links will be in the description below. If you're new to Elden Ring modding, you can also check out my other videos on exporting Elden Ring models and also on Soulstruct. Let's get started. First thing we want to do is use UXM to unpack the Elden Ring game files. Just click the browse button and then search for your eldenring.exe file and then click unpack. This will take a few minutes. Once it's finished, then we can go ahead and close out of this. And then we want to browse to our Steam library and go into Steam apps, common, and Elden Ring, and then our game folder. And now we want to go to parts. And then in here, we want to search for our binder file. That is going to be WP underscore A underscore 0100. Now we have two files here. This one is the low detail and this one is the high detail. We want the high detail, so we'll go ahead and copy this and paste it into our project folder. Now we're going to go back and then we want to go back to the Elden Ring root folder and we want to grab our regulation bin, copy that and paste it. Okay, so now we have that. What we want to do is go back to our tools folder here, open up WitchyBND. We're going to grab our binder file and drag it on top of WitchyBND, and it's going to unpack it. Now we go back to our project folder, and we now have the unpacked files. So the XML file, that's the metadata. We're not going to worry about that. The flavor file, that's for our dagger. The TPF file, that is actually our textures. And then this flavor file, this is for the scabbard. We're not going to worry about that. Now we're going to take our TPF file and do the same thing. We're going to drag it on top of the WitchyBND. Now we go back and now we have this TPF folder. Okay, so again, not worried about the XML file. These first three files, these are the textures for the scabbard. Not going to worry about that. These are the textures here for the dagger itself. Now you'll notice that they end in a letter. This one is A for albedo. That is our color map. M, that is for metal. And N is for our normals. So now we have all of our files unpacked. Next thing we want to do is jump into Blender and start modeling. Okay, so now we're in Blender. Go ahead and hit N for the tool panel. Now you should have installed Soulstruct. If you did, then you'll have the flavor tab over here. Go ahead and click on that and go ahead and go to import and we're going to import any flavor and then go to your project folder. Mine is right here and then we're going to go ahead and go into our unpacked folder and then we're going to select our WPA 0100 flavor. Click import. Okay, so we have our dagger imported. As you can see, we got the dummies and the armature also imported. First thing I'd like to do is go up to the viewport shading and check to see if we have our textures. And there we have it. Okay, and go back to normal shading. All right, so first thing I want to do is go into our front view, number pad 1. All right, so now we want to go into x-ray mode. Go up here and click on toggle x-ray. All right, and then we want to make sure that we are in edit mode. So then go into vertex. All right, so make sure we toggle x-ray mode on again. So now we're going to do some super S-tier modeling here. Is we are going to go actually into edge mode. And then we're going to go ahead and do shift select on every other edge here. Maybe not that one. We'll see. Now we want to go ahead and scale. So we're going to go ahead and do S for scale. And then we want to scale on the x-axis. So we're going to do X. And now, as you can see, we're just constrained to the x-axis. All right, so we're just going to bring these in a little bit. I think we'll go with that. Doesn't look great. I'm not real sure I like that. I think, you know what? Undo that. And we're going to undo that one. We're going to go S and then X. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, so we're going to just go ahead and scale that in. And as you can see, that is some superb modeling. For our purposes, this is perfectly acceptable. Ideally, what we'd want to do to get this kris shape is we'd want to go ahead and add a few more loops in here. So at least one here, and so on and so forth. That'll give us a much smoother curve. But for our purposes, this will be perfectly fine. So now we have that done. We can go back into object mode. Okay, so I want to point one thing out here. First, I want to go up to our viewport shading again. So now you can see the textures on here. They do look a little stretched. Now, it's not going to be really that big of a deal on something this small. You're not really going to see it that up close, so the texture stretching is going to be kind of minimal. However, if you notice, I go into vertex mode, all right, and then we go ahead and drag this around. Whoop, not that way. Let's do this. And you can see it's stretching. So if you were to do this on a larger model, then you'd want to go ahead and make sure that you fix the textures. But because this is kind of a quick and dirty model swap, and it's going to be a smaller model, we're not going to worry about the textures. Now we're going to go ahead and get this imported into our flavor editor. What we have to do is actually export this as an FBX. So now with our dagger selected, go to File, and then Export, and Export FBX, and then we're going to go ahead and save this to our project folder and then export. We're not going to worry about any of the options here. So that is all the modeling. Now the fun begins. We can go ahead and start our model swap. So we're going to go ahead and jump into the flavor editor. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and open up our flavor file in our flavor editor. But before that, I want to go to our project folder. I want to make a copy of this, and then we're going to put it out here. That way, something happens when we go ahead and save over top of this. We don't have to unpack our binder file again. So just make a kind of a put a copy somewhere else. So with that done, we're going to go to our flavor editor. I'm going to open it up. Now it's going to ask you to choose your file. So we're going to go into our project folder, and then we're going to select our flavor. So now we have two separate windows here. This is our main window, and then this is our model viewer. As you can see, we have our model. To navigate, it's pretty much standard. Hold middle mouse button to pan around, or shift and left is to orbit. The scroll wheel is to zoom. Now, I'm not going to go over this in detail. We're only going to be doing a couple things in here. As you can see here, this is actually the mesh information. So we can go ahead and hide, and we can select, and then apply a simple skin, and we can duplicate it and everything like that. But we don't really need to do anything with this one. So what we want to do first is go ahead and go up to File, Model, and then Import. And then we want to go to where our project folder is, and then we want to select our FBX file. So we got that selected. Now on the right hand side here, you'll see a few things. It auto populates with the mesh name. We got the MTD selector. This is actually a drop down for our material. And then we got weighting mode. This is the vertex weights. So first we're going to go ahead and change this to static, since this is a static object. It's not deformable or anything like that. Okay, so we're going to go into our material, and then we're going to scroll down. So we want to select the WP underscore A underscore 0100. That is our textures for the dagger. All right, so now we have that selected. We want to go ahead and open. And now, as you can see, it has added our awesomely modded dagger, which is now a kris dagger, but it's in the wrong orientation. That's simple to fix. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up here. Now we have a second entry, and this is index one, and we're going to select it. And then we're going to come over here to modifiers, and we're just going to flip the YZ axis. And there we have it. So now that's in the right orientation. So we can go ahead and just hide the original for now. Next thing we want to do is go over to our materials tab. This window is a little funky. What we're going to need to do is extend this out a little bit and drag these in. So now we have the other half of our window. So what we want to do is for our index one, we have a few options here. We got edit textures, viewer highlight, and add preset, apply and delete. View highlight, that's gonna basically just highlight the object for the textures, and then edit textures is the one that we want. So click on that, and now we have all these textures here. This is going to be fairly simple. All we have to do is go up here and click apply matte bin textures. Since this is the first time running it, what we need to do is we need to go ahead and search for our materials So that is actually going to be in our game folder here. I'm going to go down to material, and then we're going to select all material. This is the main material binder file. This is actually imported the textures, but as you can see, there's no texture on here. So this is the actual data that's stored in the binder file. What we need to do is attach the textures as a reference. So we're going to go ahead and click browse on the first one, and then we're going to go to our project folder. Where are you? There you are. And then in the TPF folder, we want to go ahead and select our albedo map. So it's going to be this one. I'm going to open. And as you can see, it's already put our color map on. So we're going to do the same for the normals. It's going to be this one. And then the same for the metal. So now we have our dagger modified into a kris dagger. We now have our textures referenced. So all we have to do now is actually export it back as a flavor file. But before we do that, what I want to do is go ahead and delete the old data, or the original data. So we're going to go ahead and check delete for index 0, click OK, and then we're going to go back over to mesh, and then for index 0, we're going to select it, and then come over here and delete selected. Okay, that way we don't have any duplicate information when we export this. So now what we want to do is go up to file, and then we want to save as, and then we're going to go ahead and go back into our binder file folder here, and we're going to just save it over top of the original. This is why I went ahead and backed it up. So if this doesn't work, then we can just redo it without having to re-unpack everything. So we're going to go ahead and save. Yes, we're going to replace it. Now all we have to do is repack our files. Okay, so we're almost finished. What we want to do now is go ahead and repack our files. So we're going to go into WitchyBND, go back to our project folder, and then we're going to go ahead and drag the folder over and drop it down onto WitchyBND. And it's going to repack it. There we go. Now we have our newly packed DCX file, and then we got our regulation file in here. As you can see, it made a backup of the original. So next thing is to go to Modengine, go into the mod folder, and then we're going to create a new folder, and we're going to call it parts. All right. And then we're going to go ahead and take our bin file and copy it, and we're going to put it in the parts folder. Okay, and now we're going to take the regulation bin file, copy that, and then we're going to put it right here in the mod. All right, so now if we've done everything right, when we go to run the game, we should see our modded dagger. First thing, you want to make sure your game's in offline mode at the very least. Best thing to do is use the easy anti-cheat disabler that you can find on Nexus Mods. I'll put a link in the description for it too. But what we want to do here is go to the launch mod, eldenring.bat. Now, before we launch this, you want to make sure that Steam is running or it won't actually launch. So let's go ahead and open this up. Okay, and as you can see, we now have our kris dagger. Now, you can tell that the textures are on there, but they're a little dark. We will address that in another video. But for right now, that is really all there is to doing a model swap. Anyone that has no modding experience should be able to do this without any problem. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, please like and subscribe for more 3D modeling and modding tutorials. Catch you in the next one. Later.